We're here to talk about unusual looking birds with weird plumage that can turn up in our gardens in winter.
And also the confusion that plumage abnormalities can cause when trying to identify different species at this time of year.
And at this time of year, it's really easy to find birds. The trees have lost their leaves, birds are moving around looking for food, so we can see more in our gardens and green spaces.
But there are always some birds that can take us by surprise and that don't appear as we expect them to. So we also have lots of inquiries about birds with plumage abnormalities at this time of year.
And what sort of abnormalities are we talking about here?
So mostly we get inquiries about leucism. True leucism is a genetic condition where there's a lack of melanin pigment in the skin and in the feathers. And this causes white patches of feathers, which are usually symmetrical, or overall white plumage. You can get other genetic conditions as well, like dilution, which causes paler feathers, and non-heritable causes. Dietary imbalance, for example, can cause progressive greying. And then we have inquiries about albino birds, which are usually completely white, and melanistic birds, which are darker or have darker patches.
Can we report our sightings to anyone?
Yes, so you can actually report sightings to the British Trust for Ornithology. They have an abnormal plumage survey. And although we don't have a survey ourselves, the Wildlife Inquiries team love to have sightings of weird and wonderful wildlife sent in. So we're always happy to help with IDs as well. And we've had some great sightings sent in recently.
What's the difference between a leucistic bird and an albino bird?
So leucistic birds are commonly seen compared to albino birds, which are extremely rare. Albino birds have a genetic mutation which prevents complete melanin production and results in a complete lack of pigment. So that means that they have red or pink eyes as opposed to leucistic birds, which retain their normal dark eyes. They're also very prone to predation because they have really poor eyesight, whereas leucistic birds tend to fare quite well in the wild.
Now, during the colder months, we can get some other unusual species turning up in our gardens and local green spaces, can't we?
That's right. So there can be some confusion between leucistic robins and female black redstarts because of the similar size and shape. We also get some confusion between leucistic garden birds and snow buntings.
Snow buntings, wow.
Globally, snow buntings actually breed in Scandinavia, Alaska, Canada and Greenland. So in the UK, they're mainly seen as winter migrants along the coastal areas of the UK. But there is a small breeding population in Scotland as well.
But they're not likely to turn up in your garden, are they?
Unlikely, but you never know.
So while you may not get a snow bunting on your bird table this winter, seeing a leucistic or albino bird would be a real treat.